Hello everyone, welcome to our subject web technology. So in the previous topic 4 we have seen about HTTP response message and web clients. So in HTTP response message we have seen about various header fields associated with the HTTP response that was generated by the web server, okay. And then web client we have seen the basic functionalities of the web browsers and also the additional features the web browsers are availing to the client, okay. So the main feature of the web browser is used to render the web pages that was responded by the web server. Then today we are going to see about web server, okay. So web server is a machine, okay. It's a computer that has both hardware and software. The main purpose of the web server is used to service the client, okay. It is used to provide HTTP service to the web client. Web server is the resource where our main websites run, okay. So client is nothing but just it sends a request to access the websites where the website is resided. Website is usually resided in web server. Mainly the web server and the web client communicates via HTTP protocol on top of after establishing the connection, TCP/IP connection. So on top of it, the client and the server communicates via HTTP protocol. HTTP stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol. In this today's class web server, we are going to see a web server called as Apache Tomcat, and that too version 5.0 we are going to see. And in our laboratory section you will be installing the Apache Tomcat web server, and you will be running sites on that, okay. This is few exercises you will be running using the Apache Tomcat web server. So today we are going to see the basic functionalities of the web server and one example of that web server, Apache Tomcat. So the main feature of the web server is, as I said, it responds the web client. So for this it involves the numerous steps for servicing the web client. The very first step here is the server calls an TCP software and waits for connection request, okay. So the server and the client need to be in internet. It means the connection must be established, and after establishing the connection the server will wait for the connection request. So the server will dedicate a separate subtask for handling the connection. Then that subtask will establish this TCP connection, and it will start waiting for receiving the request from the client, okay. Once the step number 4, once the server receives the request from the client, it examines the client header part, and it will get to know which client the request has come, and the server will run n number of multiple sites, of course. So we will be saying that as a virtual host. For example, if you take any education institution, say for example college.com, okay, simply I am telling college.com, that institution will have n number of departments like computer science, then information technology, electronics and communication department, n number of departments it will run. So each and every department will have its own website, something like www.it.college.com. It means the college.com, that host will have separate website for IT, then cs.college.com, ec.college.com. Yes or no? So these are all virtual hosts. Now all these hosts will run on a single machine. And all the virtual host ID will be represented by a single IP address. So the software will have a The server software, the server will dedicate a separate software to identify the different virtual host. Okay, so once the virtual host has been identified where the client has requested, the server will start responding back based on the request, whether the client request a file or a program or whatever the kind of information, the server will respond back once after identifying the right virtual host in that machine. Okay, and also the server will log some kind of information about the client, so which client machine, what's the IP address and the status code for that client. It will log those kind of information in a log file which was run separately in the server, and after the service has been done successful transfer, the client initiates the connection closed. Okay, till then the server will keep opening its connection. That's it about the server features. Okay, I'll repeat the virtual host. So a web server can run a single website or multiple websites using the same software and the hardware resources. Okay, so all the websites will refer to the same IP address. Okay, that is said to be the virtual host. And let's have a little introduction about the server history. In 1990s, the web server started existing. So NCSA, a corporation called NCSA, National Center for Supercomputing Application. So NCSA that has developed the server called as HTTPD, okay, an open software, open web server in the 90s. Then later when it stops its development, the web users who are depending on that web server started developing the update for that web server, and that update is said to be the Apache server. Later it is renamed into Apache server in 1995. Then there comes a competitor for that Apache server is Microsoft Internet Information Server. So IIS, okay, this is Microsoft Internet Information Server, and both the web servers started servicing for the client, and both the server also support Java programs to run. So to run a Java program, both the server will have a separate software called a servlet container. Okay, so to run a Java program in the web server, there must be a software called a servlet container. So that servlet container will provide a Java virtual machine. Hope you might have come across in your earlier semesters about JVM, okay, Java virtual machine that runs the Java programs in web server named as a servlet. Okay, so servlet container is nothing but a software to run a Java program in the server, both in Apache server and a Microsoft Internet Information Server. Now one such servlet container is said to be a Tomcat. So Tomcat is the an example for servlet container, and later as the time evolves, the Tomcat become a standalone web server. So today we are having Apache Tomcat web server. Okay, initially Tomcat was developed as a servlet container, and later it was evolved as a standalone Tomcat web server. And in our laboratory exercise, we will be installing the Tomcat web server and we will be doing few exercises on that. Okay, so this is the little history about the web server. And coming to the configuration of server, we are going to see an example for Tomcat web server. Okay, so mainly broadly speaking, server configuration is divided into two parts: external communication and internal communication. So external communication will take care of HTTP communication. Okay, so and internal communication, that's nothing but the actual processing of the Java programs. So here in Tomcat web server has two Java packages that services this two: Coyote package is the one that takes care of external communication, establishing the communication between the client and the server. Okay, HTTP 1.1 communication. So that will be handled by the Tomcat Coyote package, and Catalina is the true package for running the actual servlet container. And now we will be looking around some of the parameters involved in both the packages. The Coyote package, this is for establishing the communication for web server and the client. Okay, some of the important parameters that affect the external communications are the IP address and the port number. Okay, which we have discussed the port number in the previous topic itself. The main parameters that affects the external communication are what's the IP address of the machine requesting, and through which port the request has come, and number of subtasks during server initialization. It means how many TCP connection the server will able to respond it. So that's the number of subtasks that gets established, that gets initialized during the server startup, and maximum number of threads. It means the number of TCP connection the server could respond at any time. Okay, the maximum number of TCP connection request in queue. It means once when the maximum number of TCP connection is full, and how many requests till the server will put it in a queue so that it will respond back once the current request has been completed. Okay, and one more parameter is connection timeout. It means how the client can initiate the connection close, or the server could this connection timeout says how long the server could be idle when the request has been serviced by the when the client request has been serviced by the server. Okay, and these parameters will highly affect the performance of the server. So for that there is a separate tool available to simulate these parameters. By varying these parameters the server's performance can be visualized. Okay, some of the tools available today are load generations or stress test tool. So using these tools, the server we could tune the server performance by varying these parameters to have more optimization of the server. And next we are going to see about the parameters that affects the servlet component. So Catalina Java package is the one that that service the servlet container. That means that's the actual Java programs, that's the package that runs the Java program called as servlets. Okay, so in web server the Java programs are termed as servlets. Okay, some of the parameters that affect the functionality of the internal the parameters that affects the server programs or which client machine may send the HTTP request to the server. Actually the HTTP request will be sent to the server for to get information by the client. Okay, so here the first parameter is which client machine may send the request to the server. I think almost all the client which sends a request via HTTP could be serviced by the server, and which virtual host are listening for the client request. Okay, as I said, a server will have a number of virtual hosts, and when a request has been sent by the client, it's up to the server to identify which host the request has come and which should be serviced, which host has to respond back that request. Okay, that should be identified by the server, and what kind of logging information the server must handle it. Okay, so logging information means the IP address, who is requesting the request, and what's the status code of that request. Everything must be logged. Okay, and how the path portion of the request URI will be mapped to the server's file system or other resources. So it's up to this it is up to this package to handle it, Catalina package to handle the request URI. Okay, request URI means the web client request will be in different parts that was separated by /, is it not? So that should be handled by this package, and whether or not the server's resource will be password protected. If the server's page is password protected, only the protected or the only the legitimate user can access that web resources. For that, the server has to identify whether the request has been by the registered or the authenticated user or not. Okay, so these are the some of the parameters under the Catalina package that affects the internal processing of the server. And apart from that, there are n number of components in the server, and few components we are going to see it now. Connector in Tomcat, the mainly these components are available to achieve all these goals: connector, host, logger, realm, and val. Okay, so connector is nothing but this component takes care of HTTP 1.1 communication protocol. Okay, so this is found in the conf directory server.xml. Here the sum of the parameters, it is mentioned here: port 9999, protocol, connection timeout, redirect port. So redirect port in this sense, when a request has been come and that was not serviced by the server, and that to fulfill the request, that page has to be redirected to somewhere else. So that redirection port could be mentioned here. We can make changes in these files. Okay, the files are located in server.xml. So that's it. Then some of the fields of the server components are accept count. This is nothing but the number of TCP connections that could be accepted, connection timeout, the IP address. It means which machine could send a request. If the IP address is nothing, it means any machine can send a request to the server. And the port number, minimum spare threads, maximum threads, maximum spare threads. So minimum spare thread means during server initialization, the number of subtasks, it means the number of TCP connections are allowed, and maximum thread means at runtime, the maximum TCP connection is allowed at any time, and maximum spare thread means the maximum number of threads that should be kept idle at any time. So these are some of the fields that affects the servicing of the server. Okay, so these are all connected to the connector component of the web server. And next is a host. So host in the sense, when we run a web server in our own machine, that machine will be generally seeing as a local host. That is again we could make changes in those host names, which is located in the same file name conference/server.xml. okay, so when we run a server in our own machine, so that machine will be seeing as a local host. Okay, so here the host name is localhost, application base is web apps. Web apps means the web application. Okay, so any website component that performs some functions for the web user is said to be web apps. So here website will provide information to the web client. So the web apps, okay, app base is web apps. This is the directory where the resource gets resided. Okay, so web apps, examples we could have day-to-day activities will be doing these things: online form filling, shopping carts, word process, spreadsheets, audio video creation, edition, file conversion, file scanning, email programs. These are some of the web applications I have mentioned here. And coming to the fields, our web apps mean the resources, this the directory where our resources, where the server will locate our resources in this directory. Okay, so what kind of information, what kind of file you could put in this web apps means the application could be either web application archive or organized unpacked resource, either one we can put it in this directory. Okay, so that's what the field unpack vars equal to true, a boolean variable is set to true, it means this directory will accept an organized unpacked resources also. Then the another field auto deploy is equal to true, it means the server will automatically identify that resource once the resource is available in the web apps directory. Okay, so we the user no need to mention it each and every time manually. So when we enable the auto deploy is equal to true, when we put some resource in the directory, that will be automatically identified by the web server. Okay, so when we design a when we develop a website and if we deploy it, so we have to deploy it in a specific directory, then only the web server will identify our resources. So here web apps is the directory where we will put all our resources, that gets automatically identified by the web server by enabling this field auto deploy is equal to true. So these things you will be seeing it practically in the laboratory section. And moving on to the another main component of the server, logging. So logging means recording the information about the server activities. So mainly that will be handled by the server component named as Valve. Okay, Valve component. So this is the access log for the Tomcat server. The main fields are class name is equal to this one. This is the class that will handle all the operations, and all the directory information will be logged into the, all the access log will be logged into the directory named as log, and the directories and the field prefix and suffix. The prefix says the directory name it should follow, and the suffix is the directory name that should end, and the kind of information that gets logged into the logged into this file is said to be these things. Okay, we'll see one by one. Percentage H, it means the client machine, remote host machine, who is sending a request, and when the resource is password protected, whether the user has been logged in or not. So that will be that information is identified by percentage L. Then percentage U, in the sense remote user, whether that user was authenticated or not, if that requester resource page is password protected, that information. Then slash percentage T indicates the date and time of the request, and percentage R indicates the start line of the HTTP request, and percentage S is the status code of the response by the server, and percentage B indicates the length of the byte, length in terms of byte sent by the server in terms of response to the web request. Okay, in short, and this pattern is equal to, you can mention all these things as common, which represents this one, percentage of H, L, U, T, R in double quotation, S, B. Okay, so this is the kind of information that gets logged into this directory log. Okay, so this is an example. So this is the host name, and this is the user authenticator. So when the page is password protected, here the user is admin, and the user's request date and time has been mentioned, and this is the get request URI followed by the followed by the protocol, and this is the status code. 200 means success, 920 means the length of the response in terms of bytes. 920 bytes has been responded back to the client. And coming to the access control, it means who can access the web resources. As I said earlier, If the web page is password protected, nobody could access it directly. Only the authorized user can access it. Okay, so and again, the users can be categorized into admin, developer, and the general user. Okay, so those things will be managed by the role name. Okay, so there are two stages at the web server. One is database of the usernames with password and the list of the roles. Okay, the owner of the website have the full control over running the web pages where they need to place. If they want to edit it in the future, only that user have the rights to edit it, the administrator or the developer. End user means we, the user who is accessing the information from the web page, so are the end user. Okay, so we need to categorize the developer, or the developer has to categorize who has the rights to update the pages and who has the rights to view the pages. So for viewing, they are normally coming under to end user category. The developer and the administrator has the full rights to do any update or patchworks in the websites. Okay, certain users can only be accessed by users who belong to certain roles. Okay, so it means the administrator has the full rights, or the end user has only the limited rights of viewing. These mechanisms are controlled by the web server component called as realm. Okay, so admin role is required to run the Tomcat administration tool, as like the general user cannot have the full control over the web server. So the general user can request as a service from the web server. That's it. The administrator and the developer has the full control over the websites and the web server. And moving on to secure servers. So generally, if the server is not secure, it means vulnerable. Vulnerable in the sense, here two kinds of attacks I have given: eavesdropping, man in the middle attack. Eavesdropping in the sense, if there is a communication between A and B, and there comes one more person called as X, who could gather the information what's going between A and B, who could eavesdrop the information what's going between A and B. That is said to be eavesdropping. Whereas man in the middle attack means, take the same example, A and B are communicating, and there comes one more person called as X, who pretends to be A, and he could transfer whatever the data he want to the B. So the B might not know that the information is coming from third person. So it will see that that information is coming from A. Okay, so in this way, it could be fooled. The data communication will be fooled by man in the middle attack. To recover from to get away from these attacks, the service between the communication between the client and the server should be protected. So by means of running a secure socket layer or some other protocol between the client and the server, so that no one could intrude in between while communicating, while the communication between A and B is taking place. Okay, so there is some protocol HTTPS, which is a secured hypertext transfer protocol. So we could run the HTTPS for sensitive information, for financial transaction. The website could definitely should run in HTTPS rather than HTTP. So HTTPS is highly secured. Okay, so where we could enable the secure communication means in the transport layer. Okay, so we have to obtain and install a certificate. A certificate means the communication between the client and the server will be it means the client and the server communication is highly secure. No one could interrupt that information. It means it is in the communication between the two will be highly encrypted. Okay, so no one in the middle could fetch the information flow between the client and the server. Okay, so configure the server in the transport layer. So transport layer in the sense, so in the network there are different layers for sending the information between A and B. In your computer network you will be learning all those different layers, like application layer, presentation layer, session layer, network layer, transport layer, data link layer, physical layers. So each and every layer will save its own purpose to have a nice and smooth communication between the client and the server. Okay, to have a secure communication between the web client and the server, we need to install a certificate that will encrypt the messages between user and between the client and the server, so that no one will attack in the middle, no one will intrude and get the information while the communication between client and the server is in process. Okay, so that's it about web servers, and here is a little assessment for you. So we have seen a web server called as the Apache Tomcat, and you could get the logo of this. And apart from that, I have given four other web servers. So these are all the web server logos. So a quick, I'll give you a quick assessment regarding these web servers. Please identify what these web servers are. Okay, so that's it. So these are the resources I have referred for this slide. Kindly go through it. And a quick recap on today's topic: web server. It's a machine, or it's a computer that has both computer in the sense a hardware and a software. So mainly to service the client request over TCP IP communication protocol under HTTP protocol. Okay, web service will be done by means of HTTP protocol, and we have seen Tomcat Apache web server and its server components like connector, logger, realm, valve, host, some of the components we have seen. Okay, and finally about how to secure your web server and client communications. Okay, so in the next class we'll see about introduction to HTML. Till then, bye for now.